Since the war in Syria, since 2011, Turkey has received 3.4 million Syrians that are registered, and we estimate that the real number is close to 4 million when you include the Syrians that are not registered. Over time, it became apparent that Syrians were not going to go home anytime soon, and they started moving more and more to the western big cities where they would have more job opportunities. Along with that came increased frictions with host communities who were losing their jobs, particularly in the unqualified sector, to Syrians. And what we observed, and particularly the summer of 2017, was that there were increasing incidents of violence between Syrian refugees and host communities. These were reflected in the media, and therefore we started to do research in July 2017, and we focused particularly on the refugee-dense neighbourhoods of Istanbul, Izmir and Ankara, where we had observed that violent incidents were taking place. When we got there, we realized that many more incidents were taking place that were not reflected in the press. There's a tendency to downplay the frictions that are taking place with Syrians. And for example, we spent a lot of time in Sultan Gazi, which is a sort of medium-sized district of Istanbul, where violent incidents had been taking place. In Sultan Gazi, we saw two types of grievances towards the influx of Syrians. One was economic, where people were saying they were losing jobs to Syrians who would take their work for less money, or economic in terms of public services being strained, hospitals being more crowded, schools getting more crowded, or rent prices going up because the demand for affordable housing was higher. So those we can sort of classify as economic grievances. And then you have these identity-related grievances where, for example, the Kurdish population, the Alevi population, which is almost half of Sultan Gazi, felt like the Sunni Arab dominance of the Syrian refugees was diluting their own identity demands, where, for example, the Kurds have had a long-running demand for Kurdish language to be accommodated in the provision of services, and it has not been met, whereas they see Arabic translation being provided in the hospitals or in the municipalities. They see extracurricular Arabic classes in schools for the Syrian refugees, and they feel like the compassion that was not shown to them when they were displaced from the southeast, for example, is now being extended to the Syrians. And so there's a level of resentment there that's, of course, compounded with these economic grievances.